Our history textbooks often talk about Razia Sultana's brief reign over Delhi, but that's as far as they're willing to go on the topic of Muslim women rulers. They don't mention the fearless Begums of Bhopal, four women who stood up against 19th century's deeply patriarchal society and ruled Bhopal for 107 years. This rule of women started during the times of the British, when Bhopal was the second largest Muslim state of India. An 18-year-old Qudsiya Begum ascended the throne after the assassination of her husband. Begum set a new pattern of women not just being titular rulers, but hands-on administrators and decision-makers. Her ascension, like the three queens who would come after her, would be opposed by both male candidates and the British East India Company. But that wouldn't stop the Begums from standing their ground, even using Queen Victoria as their model. As powerful forces destroyed many dynasties around them, the Nawab Begums successfully navigated their kingdom, despite all religious and political odds. So who were these women? And how did they break free from the norms of their times to exercise such power? The first Begum of Bhopal was Qudsiya Begum. She was not only the first female ruler of the princely state of Bhopal, but also the first woman in South Asia to legally assert the right of a Muslim woman to rule and hold power. She challenged the parda system, a custom of isolating women from the public eye by keeping them behind veils and curtains. Making way for an all-female lineage of rulers, she announced her 15-month-old daughter Sikandar as the next heir. History holds her to be fearful and benevolent in equal parts. Her days were marked by commanding and leading armies to war, while at nights she simply couldn't sit down to eat before ensuring all her subjects had eaten their meals. She convinced the state Qazi and Mufti to sign documents recognizing women's right to power, thereby setting precedents for women to lead and exercise political power. Next in line was Sikandar Begum. Sikandar allied with the British in the First War of Independence and crushed all who came in her way, thus making her the only female knight besides Queen Victoria in the British Empire. She ruled with an iron fist and defied traditional gender norms with every step she took. She played polo, practiced archery, and was a remarkable swordswoman. In an attempt to bring education to girls, she established the Victoria School of Bhopal. Her reign is still considered the golden period of Bhopal. Sikandar was followed by Shah Jahan Begum. An enthusiast of architecture and poetry, her reign saw the growth of arts and culture in the state. She even commissioned a male poet to create a collection of works of female poets in history. Under her rule, Bhopal's economy boomed. The state's rich craftsmanship enabled it to have the highest GDP contribution towards the Indian economy. Like her namesake, she built a palace called Taj Mahal, amongst other remarkable mosques and forts. She also created the first ever women's encyclopedia in India, texts educating women about their place in Islam and gaining agency over their own lives. The fourth queen of Bhopal was Sultan Jahan Begum. A strong believer in education and female health reforms, she was as strong an administrator as her predecessors. She was the first and till date the only female chancellor of Aligarh Muslim University. She introduced workshops on making blankets, soaps and saris for prisoners in jail, thereby changing the concept of punishment so that convicts could lead fruitful lives once released. The reign of the Begums of Bhopal ended with Sultan Jahan Begum's son inheriting the kingdom. But their contribution towards the political and cultural revolution in Bhopal left its mark for times to come. Their rule observed communal peace and majorly influenced the discourse of public perception of women in power. In a society still struggling to make female voices be heard, Bhopal was way ahead of its time with its matrilineal society. And in an era where women were continuously sidelined from all decision-making spaces, the Nawab Begum's long rule stood out for not just challenging religious notions and history, but embodying feminism long before it became a part of the zeitgeist.